I'm Emma. I'm here because I kind of live in this area, so I thought I'd just come and see what was happening. There was a lot of traffic. So we thought we'd bring the kids for lunch, and I met some friends.
Hi, my name's Brenda. I have just moved to Nairobi a couple of months back. And this is my second exhibition, but I just found out about the Soko Soko event, so I thought I'll just try and see how people like this stuff.
The people that started it, they themselves wanted to sell crafts. So they started it on a small basis, and then it grew and got bigger and bigger. But it was ultimately to support a charity.
With a Chega, and I'm a ceramicist, and I've been doing ceramics since almost 30 years. And I basically make one-off pieces because I like to create my own glazes. I've known Soko Soko Craft for the last 20 years. I haven't taken part in the last 10 years. And it's a good product because they actually support a lot of craft people who would not normally have a big shop. They get once a year to actually show off their art piece. So it's a good event, and it gives everybody a chance to have a little.
Okay, my name is Rachel, and I'm from Nini's Afrik Boutique.
My name is Prudence, and I'm with Nini's Boutique also. Yeah, so this is basically what we do. Products, we design them ourselves. So all this is just what we do. We have the long gladiators. We're the ones who design them. If you see them anywhere else, just know that they belong to Nini's Boutique. And then we have the short gladiators. We have the double flowers. We have all kind of whatever shoes in here.
It goes with the trend, with what clients want. So we keep on updating the stuff that we keep on getting.
My name is Dorothy Mkala. I work for Kenya Museum Society. We hold different events in the same essence of raising funds. We have what we call No Kenya More through Films. That's basically been running throughout the year now, where people come, we screen Kenyan films strictly, then they pay, they give a donation, and then that supports the museum.
Some of the projects we've supported are in Gorongocha, the slum schools. We put in water systems and hand washing facilities so they can wash their hands, and they're taught to wash their hands. Then another school, Jumbo Toto, also in Gorongocha, they had a building that wasn't very stable, and so we built them a structure of four classrooms, which they then can open up and have a hall. And this is a New Hope Children's Centre, two disabled children who, once they outgrow the school, we've built them a house so that they can stay, and so that will be theirs for the rest of their life.
Hi, I'm Ravi Shah. We're the Amazing Bazaar. We have been in this trade for 35 years. We do all antiques and reproduction furniture and knickknacks. My father started the trade. We've been traveling all around the world to get the best of best, to let Kenya have, you know, that sort of decor that they wouldn't get just in Kenya. So we source everything out and bring it for them here. Most of the furniture is original ones from the villages in India. It's all teak furniture, maybe 6 years old, depends on the age of the products. The chests were the original bridal chests that were used when the weddings were happening, or the window frames, they've reconverted those into furniture now.
My name is Chris. I brought the kids out to the Soko Soko Fair, and lovely weather, so it was just the perfect opportunity to get outdoors today. Yeah. Yeah, it's my first time here. I didn't come last year, so it's the first time for me. I think it's good. I don't know why it's once a year. It should be maybe twice or three times a year at least.
Their international cadence in special dédicace. Pense pour me résister, d'où le ventre à la vie.
I'm Andrew Kamiti. I specialize on watercolor paintings of birds, and I also do pencil drawings of wildlife, natural subjects, all found in Kenya. I travel a lot. That's where I get all my inspiration from, my travels, and anything that inspires me, as long as it's occurring naturally and it's beautiful, and I feel like painting it. It's been very successful. Yeah, I like it. The turnout has been good and the people have been responding well. The prices are very reasonable. Anyone can afford my prices. It depends on the prints are from 5,000 to 25,000. Some of them, the original paintings, will go for up to about 50,000.
My name is Adanech. I'm living here. I'm catering Ethiopian food, mostly for occasion like this. You find me so many. I'm from Ethiopia, but living in Kenya. So this is Ethiopian traditional food called injera. We have chicken sauce here. This one is chicken. This is called chickpeas.
Hi, my name is Susan, and I work for the United Nations in Somalia. I'm here in Muthaiga Market, at stall for the weekend, where a lot of the money goes to charity. And it's a wonderful place to come and to bring your children. And there's lots of different foods. There's a creche for children. There's really beautiful, beautiful clothes, beads, pictures. And the food is great. So come. Ethiopian food is unique, and they have tif, which is equivalent to our bread, but it looks like a dead sponge. But it's delicious when you use it with the food and you get your fingers into it and then you taste it. And some of the flavors are sweet, some of them are more spicy, some of them are just lovely. You want to take it home with you. This is my first time I've been in Kenya, and I've been here about 2 months. And this is the first time I've been here, and I recommend coming here to everybody.
My name is Arif Ismail, and I'm the proprietor of this company, Sunny Days Limited. We are predominantly furniture makers and retailers. Mainly dealing with garden furniture and antique Lamu Zanzibar style antique furniture. We have been participating at the Soko Soko Bazaar for the last 5-6 years. It's one of the craft sort of fairs, craft fair venues. To participate in any sort of exhibition, there is always a benefit because you get the exposure to new customers. Yeah, you can actually display new products where people can see. And yes. Kenyan market is good. We cater for the hotel industry and also individuals. We believe that our products are priced at a very reasonable level, considering the fact that we deal with hardwood. Unlike most of the furniture that is imported in the country from, shall I say, China and Malaysia and all these places, which is generally made out of MDF, that's not solid wood at all. So all our furniture is always made from hardwood using teak or mahogany.
I am Kern. I am 9 years old. I go to the school Premier Academy. I do football at Farasi Lane. It's called SAG Soccer. They have different age categories for all ages from 6 to 11. They have different level stages for each category. I play defense.
I'm Rachel Njoki.
And I'm Prudence.
And you're from Nini's Afrique Boutique.
And you're watching The Trends Show.